हेलो नमस्कार एंड आदाब टू ऑल माय फ्रेंड्स फ्रॉम योर फ्रेंड एस्ट्रोलॉजर एंड गाइड इरफान वंस मोर विथ यू फ्रॉम योर वेरी ओन चैनल एस्ट्रो एश्योरेंस। आई हैव मेड लॉट ऑफ जेनरिक वीडियोस ऑन अ लॉट ऑफ प्लेसमेंट्स ऑन योगास दोषास एंड दशा एंड ऑल्सो द इफेक्ट्स ऑफ प्लैनेट्स इन सर्टन प्लेसमेंट्स एंड इन सर्टन साइंस। नाउ आई वॉन्ट टू गेट इन टू मोर स्पेसिफिक प्लेसमेंट्स ऑफ प्लैनेट्स एंड इन स्पेसिफिक एरियाज हाउ डू दे गिव results. So I will start making generic videos, plus I will also give more specific so that you get more details about that particular placement. For example, I have already made a video about generic results about retrograde planets and how the retrograde planets will manifest, what their strengths are and how their results will come about, the probable results will come about. Today I want to talk about something which is a more challenging placement in horoscopes, and which is about the placement of a specifically the dasha period of a retrograde malefic planet, which means a functional malefic if it is retrograde in motion and placed in a challenging house and sign, especially if it's also with other malefics. Then what kind of results may come by, what kind of effects it will give in its dasha period, and how one can face the various challenges that such a retrograde malefic can throw up during its dasha and antardasha, and what could be the remedies that one could employ to face such a placement in your horoscopes. So let's start with first understanding the strength of a retrograde planet. Though I have already made a video on retrograde planets, but right now because we are talking about a retrograde malefic planet, so let's understand a strength of the retrograde planet and what it is from the shlokas. Saravali says the contribution made by a planet that is in Vargottama own sign, own decanate or own navamsa should be doubled. If it is retrograde or in exaltation, the figure should be troubled, which means the strength of a retrograde planet as well as a exaltation planet is more or less the same, which is 3 times its normal strength. Then why is the retrograde planet directly not called a exalted planet? Why is it called a retrograde planet and its results are seen differently if its strength is almost the same as an exalted planet? The difference between the two is the exalted planet is placed so strongly, its effects can more or less be easily predicted and probable results can be put forth. The challenge with the retrograde planet is the retrograde planet is more a rogue planet, which means that it will give you such effects, such results which sometimes cannot be anticipated. So so retrograde planets will give you generally those results which you cannot anticipate, which will come suddenly to you, strong results will come to you, both good and bad, and that's why it is tougher to predict the results of or the probable predictions for a retrograde planet, as well as how to understand the dasha and antardasha of a retrograde planet. And one easy thing about a retrograde malefic is you can take it for granted that a retrograde malefic in the horoscope in a challenging position will give you more challenges than more ease and more abundance or more prosperity or more goodness. That is a given. That means a retrograde malefic functional malefic planet in the horoscope will throw up more challenges in its dasha and antardasha than normally. Now, while a planet is retrograde, I am taking out a retrograde exalted planet. For the simple reason is that various shlokas have also told us that a retrograde but exalted planet generally loses all its strength because it becomes a case of +3 and -3. And various shlokas have said that. There is some truth to it, not complete truth to it, but I will address it some other time. Today, I am talking about a purely retrograde planet which is also a functional malefic in your horoscope. So generally, what is the classical definition of a retrograde planet? The classical definition of a retrograde planet is a planet which is in its normal course of its orbit. However, in comparison with the motion of the Earth, it seems to be going backward. It seems. It is not actually going backward. No planet goes backward. It is going in its continuous state of motion, But it seems that it is going in a backward motion because the speed of Earth is faster than that of the other planet. And so the planet seems to go backwards. But because it goes backwards, the rays of that planet that come to the Earth or its influence goes slow and slow on a backward fashion or becomes slow and becomes lower and lower. However, the retrograde planet is also a planet which is closest to the Earth. And that's why also its speed seems to be waning and it seems to be going backwards. So, in effect, that's why a retrograde planet is the strongest. But what is the understanding of a retrograde planet, though it seems to be going backwards, is that it is very, very strong. The other thing, the classical definition of a retrograde planet is that it also gives the results of the house and sign previous to it, which means if a planet is retrograde in the Lagna in Aries, then it will also give the results of the 12th house and the 12th sign, which is Pisces. So that is the classical definition and the classical understanding. And why is it said that the retrograde planet will give the results of the previous sign and previous house? It is like saying that if in your previous births there have been some pending karmas which you have not completed, then you are allowed, you are given the permission to complete it in this life. It is like when you are in college, you are allowed to give a supplementary exam. So if you are finishing one term and going into the next term, the next class, but there are certain papers which you have not cleared, then you are allowed to proceed, you are allowed to get promoted, yet you need to give the supplementary exam as well. If you don't give that, or if you fail in that, then your promotion is withheld. So that is like a retrograde planet. It's a permission given to you, it's an allowance given to you, it's an opportunity given to you to correct the karmas of the previous births also. And hence the retrograde planet seems to be going slower through the sign because of its seemingly backward motion. So that means a lot of karma in the house that it is placed that you will need to do, and of the last sign and last house. So you will have to do both. But the biggest thing about the retrograde planet is that if the retrograde planet is at the beginning of a sign, then it tends to give the results of the last sign and last house as well. However, if the retrograde planet seems to be retrograde in your natal horoscope, which is almost closer to more than 15, 16, almost till 25 degrees, then it is too entrenched within the house and sign. Then its effects of the last house and sign are very, very less. Which means more work should be done about the house that it is placed in rather than about the house or sign that is the last or the previous one. So that is an important thing for us to note. Jupiter in the first house, either in Cancer, Scorpio and Pisces, makes one careless but generally fortunate in money matters unless Jupiter is retrograde. Now what does the shloka mean? It means that Jupiter in the water signs tends to be a little bit careless, that makes the nature a little bit careless, especially if it's in the Lagna. In the Lagna, Jupiter and Mercury are two planets which get highest directional strength. So Jupiter in the Lagna makes one a little careless when it's in the water signs, even if it's in its own sign, which is Pisces, but makes the person fortunate in money matters, which means Lagna, Jupiter in a friendly sign, Scorpio as well as Cancer are friendly signs to it. In fact, in Cancer it is exalted, whereas Pisces it's its own sign. So definitely it's not in an unfortunate position, or it's not in a malefic sign, it is not an inimical sign to itself rather than malefic, but it will give you fortunate, it will make you fortunate unless it is retrograde, which means that There are always challenges to a planet, and if it is retrograde, so that fortunate tendency of Jupiter will be reduced, or there will also be challenges which come in the line of fortune being made. So it doesn't say that you will not make a fortune because it's in a friendly sign, but it says that unless it's retrograde, then you will not be as fortunate. And so a planet which is retrograde, even in a friendly sign, even in its own exaltation sign, will give you challenges. In fact, in an exaltation sign, it will, because the exaltation is cancelled because of its retrograde motion, it becomes in fact less strong. But in a friendly sign, an own sign, or its Mool Trikon sign, a planet has a lot of strength and will give you much better benefits as well. So just keep this in mind. Any planet which is retrograde, the fortunate part of its manifestation will be slow, even if it is benefic, even if it's strongly placed, even in a friendly sign, own sign, or even in a Mool Trikon sign, even in a house where it gets the highest directional strength. Yet a retrograde planet will take its time to bring about its fortunate bit. That means to make you lucky, to make you fortunate, and to make you get gains of your life, it will be slower, it will be more through hard work, and it will be through patience. So the biggest learning that you can get out of a retrograde planet is, wherever retrograde planet is placed, you have to be more patient. The more malefic the planet is, for example, if it's a Leo ascendant native, then Saturn is a malefic planet for a Leo ascendant native. Then if Saturn is retrograde, then you can be rest assured that you will get challenges in life, you will get issues in life, because it is retrograde Saturn, and you will have to be more patient about issues related to Saturn, which is issues related to the 6th house and the 7th house for a Leo ascendant native, as well as where Saturn is placed. So in matters of dealing with colleagues, matters of dealing with people who work under you or below you, matters of related to your relationship, partnership, working with other people, your day-to-day dealings, all these will not be easy for you, will be challenging for you, and you will have to be patient, and you will have to work on them, and over a period of time the results will manifest. This is more so because Saturn is the planet which is retrograde. A retrograde planet by its tendency will give you slower results, will make you work hard, will make you show as if progress is being made, and suddenly the progress will seem to be at the standstill. That's what a retrograde planet does. The retrograde planet will make you feel as if progress is being made. One step forward, two step forward, and suddenly one step backward. Suddenly one step forward and two steps backward. So you really don't know whether you're making any progress or not. It leaves you frustrated, it leaves you anxious. That is the tendency of a retrograde planet, and that's why it is called as a rogue planet, because sometimes it makes you feel as if you're going very fast and you're doing good progress, and suddenly something comes up and this seems to be a challenge. Right now, during the pandemic, in the current month of August, when both Jupiter and Saturn are retrograde, we see the life slowly coming back to normal, limping back to normal. But the moment lockdown is open, suddenly you get news that it is spiking, and again the lockdown is put in force again. And this is happening since the last 3-4 months, we have seen this. So that is the result of a retrograde planet. It makes things not very clear. We don't see whether progress is being made or not. And sometimes we think the progress is being made, and suddenly we get to know that progress is not being made. Sometimes we think progress is not being made, but suddenly things seem to be good. So this dicey situation, this situation of uncertainty, a retrograde planet gives, and that's why you can never be too sure what results you will face during the dasha and antar dasha of a retrograde planet, and during the sadhisati of Saturn, if Saturn is retrograde. So that is definitely a challenge. So in general, what are the results of a retrograde planet? A retrograde planet gives the results of, as I said, the house and sign that is placed in, you have to work harder on it. It is almost as if that you want to revisit something, you want to redo something. And that's why a retrograde planet will always want to make you feel that if you got a chance. So for example, if Jupiter is retrograde in the horoscope of a woman, then there will always be something about her relationships where she will feel that, you know, I could have done this better, or if I could get a chance of doing this again, I would probably do this. My last relationship got spoiled because I was not able to do this. If I get a chance, I will do this, you know, better, or I will do this differently. And if you get into another relationship for a woman, when she has a Jupiter retrograde, she will try to correct things, you know, and she will try to change things how she dealt in the last relationship. However, to a large extent, the same things seem to play out again in spite of her best efforts. And that's why it seems as if you have made some progress, where you have moved away from a bad relationship, you have got into a new relationship, one step backward, but again the similar kinds of issues again start, and you feel that you have gone back to the same position again. So you took a step forward, but you went back to that same situation in the last relationship where you were facing challenges. That's what a retrograde Jupiter will do, for example, for a woman, because Jupiter represents a man in a woman's life, a partner. If Venus is retrograde in a man's chart, the challenges on materialism will be there. You will feel you made some progress in getting ahead in business, suddenly there will be a stalling. You will feel that you have done better in terms of your relationship. You feel as if a girl you like is about to say yes, suddenly she comes back and she says, no, I'm not interested in you anymore, or I need more time with you, for example. Sometimes if you have a problem with your spouse or your better half, you feel that you've tried to change your ways, and you've tried to mend your ways, and you've tried that, yet they feel that no, you've tried your ways, I know, but I'm no more in the relationship, for example. So this will happen with different planets and what relationships they represent, what their karakas of. If Jupiter is retrograde in a man's chart, he will feel challenges in learning. He will feel challenges in acquiring learning, in education, in higher degrees, and he will take one step forward and two steps backwards. That means there may be gaps in education, especially if Jupiter is retrograde. It will give you something related to Jupiter. Either it will make you think differently about your religion, your religiosity. You may be more spiritual rather than being religious, or it will, as it is said, a rogue planet, which means you may get attracted to different religions, or people from different religions may attract you. You may be more spiritual than religious. You may visit different kinds of spiritual places which may not be from your own culture as well. You may face ups and downs in prosperity. One step forward, two step backward, two step forwards, one step backward. That will always be there. You may have challenges, initial challenges about having children, or there may be a few years after your marriage before children come into the couple's life. So these things related to the planet will always be there. Whatever the planet is the karaka of, the retrograde planet, that will definitely give. If it's a malefic planet, then challenges and issues will be there. If Jupiter is retrograde, that too in the fifth house, pregnancy related issues will be faced by the couple. Challenges will be there in investments, because it is the fifth house. There may be times where you may face challenges with children later on in life also, where you don't get along. There may be issues to career, because fifth house is the eighth house to the tenth house. So malefic planets, especially retrograde planets, will give you setbacks, challenges, issues about the sign that they are placed in, which houses they rule, which house they are placed in, and what they are karakas of. They will always give you issues and challenges in these areas before slow progress is made. And as it is said, a retrograde planet is an opportunity for you to correct the karmas which are still pending from the previous life, which you have been allowed to carry forward. So if you are not doing anything about the learning, you are not demonstrating that you have learnt your lesson, and you are mature to the role of the planet, what the planet represents, if you don't show that, then sometimes all your life the retrograde planets, especially malefic planets, keep throwing challenges at you one after the other. It's like a ping pong game, like a table tennis game, where you don't have time to react. You hit the ball, within milliseconds the ball keeps coming back to you. So that's what a retrograde planet does. It keeps throwing the same issues at you again and again and again. Malefic challenges, troublesome challenges at you if it's a retrograde malefic, and till you show that you have the maturity to handle that. And the biggest sign that the retrograde planet gets that you are mature is to be patient and to keep doing the right thing. So it is always like you want to go back, you want to correct, you want to reset something in your life. And you will always see that because of retrograde planet in your chart, if it's a malefic, you will also see that in the dealing about that house, you will face more challenges. For example, if a planet is retrograde in the fourth house represents your material benefits. your car, your house, your material possessions, your all your domestic appliances, your jewelry, everything that money can buy is represented by the fourth house. So if there is a retrograde in the fourth house, you will find that you face challenges about that house. So there may be issues in the property. You may take time to buy a property. You may take time to buy to get loan sanctioned for a property. You will take times to pay off the EMIs. Outright buying a house may be difficult for you. You may face challenges in relations with the mother. You may have to change many houses if it's a retrograde planet, especially if it's malefic. You will also see that some of the other repair keeps coming in the house. Some of the other appliance seems to be breaking down. Your car seems to be breaking down. And the other is that you feel that you're paying a higher price than the others if a retrograde planet is malefic. So if you're buying stuff, you will find that generally you end up paying more money than the others. You don't get a good deal. You get a slightly less deal or even a bad deal than others. And you end up paying more. Sometimes you pay twice, thrice before it comes through. You're standing in the line, and when your turn comes, it seems that the booking window closes and you have to come back again. If you are booking tickets online, you find that, just when your time came, things have been sold out. So that thing a retrograde planet always does. It takes you on to the verge of victory or closure or accomplishment and pulls you back. It asks you to keep revisiting. And it also makes you pay more because you have not probably paid about it in the last life. In your last karma, you didn't pay enough, you didn't do enough. So now it's an opportunity to do about it. And that's why the strength of the planet is also given. That you were not able to do enough in the last life. So now I'm giving a stronger manifestation. I'm giving a stronger tool. I'm giving a stronger planet. Now do and show me. That's what Supreme Energy is telling you. I've given a stronger planet. I have given you another opportunity. Now show me whether you have learned your lessons or not. And so a retrograde planet, if it's malefic, means two things. One, it's a good opportunity to do things again, and it is a great opportunity to shed your karma. The Lord says in many shloka, in almost every religious book, when you face troubles, you can understand that you are shedding off the bad energy. You are improving your karma, you're improving your punya. So don't be afraid when you have a retrograde malefic and you're facing challenges. Keep an ethical behavior and over a period of time you will see that you will start getting better results. The other thing that you see about a retrograde planet is that wherever a retrograde malefic is placed, you seem to be repeating the same mistakes. While on one side you think that, oh, if I could do this, if I could change this, I would do this. Rather than buying this car, if I could go back and buy the other car, it would be good. Rather than saying no to that boy or to that girl, if I could go back and marry that person who I refuse and marry this person who I am with, you always have that feeling, And when you're buying something and you say, no, I don't want to buy this, and then you go to somebody else and buy that, then always there is a thought at the back of your mind, I shouldn't have refused that. While on one side this happens, but you keep repeating that, the same thing over and over and over again, you feel that, why didn't I listen to this? Why didn't I listen to mine? Now, one thing, very strong thing, with a retrograde malefic, the first thing that comes to your mind, do that. So if intuitively some thought comes to you, if you don't do it and you are procrastinating about it, then you get into all these doubts. Should I do this? Should I not do this? If it's a ethical behavior doing, ethical conduct you are doing, your conscience is clear, whatever the first thought comes in your mind intuitively, try and do that. You will find that you will get more success. If you sit on your haunches, if you think too much, it is like this. You want to take a house on rent, okay? You are in a new city and you find a house and you find a decent house to your liking. But there is not X or Y thing which is missing. And to look for that X and Y thing, you are missing on the ABC which you have got at the basic level. And in search of the X and Y, now when you look at other houses to rent, you will find that A, B and C all are missing or something important which is missing. And then when you go back and say, no, I want to take a house on rent, that time I refused. That house is no more there, it has already been given on rent to somebody else. So that kind of a thing happens where, and you keep repeating the same mistakes, you end up paying more price, you keep repeating, the effort, and you keep repeating the mistakes with a retrograde malefic which comes to you. If you are somebody who's prone to accidents, small accidents, you will find that you all the time will have some dashes, some scratches on your car often, because you get into that kind of a situation because of a malefic Mars, for instance. You get small hurts, small scratches, small burns, small cuts, more than others. You know, if you have a malefic planet connected to the Lagna or connected to Mars, you find that more often than not. If it's malefic Mars with Ketu, sometimes you need to go through 2 or 3 surgeries, sometimes small and sometimes major surgeries also. Because the retrograde planet keeps, repeating that thing to you, because it wants you to shed the karma. And so going through the troubles of pain and issues and challenges and frustrations and anxieties, the karmic debt is also being shed. The Jataka Bharanam says, Vilomagami Grah Pakale Sthanarth Sukhani Yati Chalani Pravashi Latva Ativa Jan Tora Loke Mahatva Pachayatvam Meva. I translate, in the dasha of a retrograde planet, there is lack of stability in place of residence, wealth and happiness, living in foreign land, and loss of honor in the world. So if it's a dasha of a retrograde planet, especially if it's malefic, then the issues and challenges will be more. There is also a chance that your reputation may be tainted, or you have to do a lot of explanation for your actions, or people don't find right thing or righteousness in your actions, or people don't approve of your actions, or people don't like your actions, people don't like your work, your managers and supervisors are not happy with the work that you have put in. So that kind of issue you may face. And you may also face losses in terms of your material benefits, your investments. If you have invested in shares and stocks, you will find that you are doing good, and suddenly you find during the dasha or antar dasha of the malefic planet, if it's retrograde, or a malefic over the natal position of the retrograde planet during the transit, you will find suddenly the stock market crashing, money being lost, or deals getting locked up. There is no progress, and so lack of progress and stagnation of issues can be seen during the dasha of a retrograde planet as well. Now the other thing, if a planet is retrograde, wherever it is placed, whichever house it transits over, say Saturn or a Jupiter, the larger planets, then you will find that whichever house it goes over for that period, Jupiter transits over a house for a year. So for that 1 year, you will find you will have to revisit and complete tasks for that house, and that's what retrograde planet does. It's a very karmic position. So if Jupiter, for example, is retrograde in the Lagna, in general you may face health issues, reputation issues, moving up in society, doing good, making a lot of money. That is the generic results. However, a retrograde Jupiter in the Lagna, when it is transiting say over the fourth house, then you will find that your lot of attention will go over the fourth house, challenges and issues of the fourth house may crop up again and again, and you will have to revisit things about the fourth house. You may have to do repairs, you may have to shift houses, you may have to buy a car or repair the car, or you may suddenly find you will need to spend more time with the mother. Mother's health may go through ups and downs, and you will have to spend more time to correct things about that house. So it's an opportunity when a retrograde planet in the natal chart is going over any house or in transit, you will find a lot of correction to be done in that house. That opportunity will keep coming to you again and again. In the sixth house, it is about reworking on your projects, reworking with your colleagues, treating or a chance to repair your relations with colleagues at work, to put in better work, to focus on your career and to move ahead, and to let go of enmities, to let go of emotional baggage that you're carrying about career. That's what it means. So wherever the retrograde planet is transiting, you will see that challenges and issues in that period will keep manifesting. If it's the transit which is happening at the time of transit, if the dasha and antar dasha of the planet is also on of a malefic retrograde, then you will find that more issues will come up and you may have to put in effort double and treble the normal, and you may have to spend more time, you will have to spend more money, and you will have to focus more energies about the issues of the particular house. Where a retrograde planet which is malefic is transiting over a house, and the dasha and antar dasha of the houses of the planet is also on. Retrograde Jupiter transiting in the difficult 12th house denotes enthusiasm is locked away, the identity has difficulties in preparing and things to happen. A retrograde planet will give you stronger manifestation of the house that it transits. So if retrograde Jupiter in your natal chart is transiting over the 12th house, then it will show you, because 12th house is a house of waste and excess. And so you will lack the enthusiasm to do any things, because whatever you do, it will come across as your effort is going to waste. Nothing is clicking, nothing is coming by. So you lose enthusiasm, you lack the energy to do things, and you remain confined to your seat, you don't want to talk to people. So the 12th house results will also come by, and strongly. So stronger manifestation of the house will come by when a retrograde malefic is transiting through that house, and the chances of you falling ill or even having to visit the clinic many times or even getting admitted to a hospital will be higher if a malefic retrograde planet is transiting through your 12th house. If a retrograde malefic planet is transiting through your 8th house, then you have to be extremely careful, because sudden upheaval giving challenges may be thrown at you. Without a warning, issues will come up to you. You may face issues coming from your in-laws to shared property, from your spouse, taxation issues, something which you have not thought about, suddenly they will crop up. For example, if your planet is retrograde in the 4th house, your car will give you some challenges, issues 2, 3, 4 times, and then suddenly it will break down. So you have visited and again and the car has broken down. So you know that, and then you feel, I've been putting so much money in the car, 4 times, 5 times it has gone to the service station and still it is not getting repaired. But you have put enough effort before the challenge, the car has completely broken down. In the 8th house, those chances don't come to you. The car suddenly breaks down without any warning. And there are strong upheavals than just the breakdown of a car. It may be that you dash your car against something suddenly and the bumper breaks and you have to end up spending, you know, thousands of rupees on the repair of the car. That kind of a thing, sudden upheaval comes in. So if you have a retrograde malefic planet in your horoscope which is not transiting through your 8th house, be extremely careful during that entire period. If it's Jupiter, for that 1 year, be very, very careful. If it's Saturn, 2.5 years, be extremely, extremely careful during the transit of Saturn over your 8th house. If Saturn is a malefic, functional malefic, and retrograde in your chart, I can't emphasize this point enough. Malefics when retrograde will cause intense evil if they are in Veda obstruction position. Planets in certain placements with reference to other planets give Vedas, will give obstructions. And so one important entity or one important thing in astrology is to look at what the Vedas are, which the obstructions given by other planets in certain positions from each other is. Especially if it's a retrograde malefic, then the obstruction will be much stronger. However, if a retrograde malefic is placed in a bad conjunction, if Saturn is retrograde and placed in a Vish dosha with Moon or a Shrapit dosha with Rahu, then it will be definitely a huge challenge. Malefic Saturn retrograde place with Mars will make you do things many times, yet results will not come by. Malefic Saturn with Sun, where it is not combusted, with at least 10 to 12 degrees difference between Saturn and Sun, will spoil your reputation, will soil your reputation. You will have to go through many issues where your self-respect will have to be sacrificed, or you will have to fight for your self-respect when malefic Saturn in your horoscope is retrograde and placed with Sun. So these conjunctions of a malefic retrograde planet with any planet will spoil the manifestation of that planet of the house,
and the houses that the malefic planet rules.
Balabhadra says, if a strong benefic planet is retrograde at birth, the native will acquire kingdom. A malefic thus found will give vices and unfruitful wanderings.
So, a retrograde malefic will give rise to more vices. That means a person will be unnecessarily be attracted towards vices. He may be forced to do wrong. He may get into addiction. He may face challenges and issues because of which he will tend to go towards that which is not the right thing to do, the ethical behavior to do. And this is also because it's a testing phase for you. A retrograde malefic is a bigger test for you than just a retrograde. A retrograde planet which is a benefic and in a friendly sign will give you opportunities to correct things, and you will have a larger chance of getting it corrected also, with some effort definitely. But a retrograde malefic will make you slog very, very hard, give you many pitfalls, give you many issues before ultimately the success will come to you. But the biggest challenge for you is to be patient and keep doing ethical behavior. The moment you move to vices, you move to take shortcuts, you get under the influence of Rahu, it is a downhill. It is the start of a downhill period for you if you allow the retrograde malefic to create havoc in your lives. Saravali talks of inauspicious results of a retrograde Saturn in the fourth. It says, if Saturn is retrograde in the fourth, he destroys the native's wife and progeny. If Saturn is retrograde and a functional malefic and placed in the fourth house, then it's very, very important that you don't create unnecessary issues about your spouse and about your domestic life. This will throw up many challenges to you. It will give you many issues to you. But the simple thing is to not try to control it, not try to rule things, but to give in and to be patient and allow the spouse to have a greater say in the house. Wherever Saturn is placed, if it's retrograde and if it is a functional malefic, allow others to take the lead and you take the back seat and depend on wise counsel to take a decision. Never take the decision on your own, because nine times out of ten you may go wrong about the decision of a house where a functional malefic is placed and if its dasha and antar dasha is on. And the biggest challenges and issues that can be brought about as a functional malefic is by Saturn, Sun and Mars. Now Sun cannot be retrograde, thankfully, and so a debilitated Sun may still give you challenges, but a debilitated Sun cannot give you as much challenges as a retrograde Saturn and Mars. If they become malefic, then your life can be really a big havoc and a bag full of challenges. Now an important one: the dasha of a malefic retrograde planet will cause wanderings like that of a wheel, evils and enmity. If a retrograde planet is malefic, then during its dasha and antar dasha, it will create unnecessary enmity for you. People who seem to be good to you suddenly may turn up against you. You may find your relationships taking a downhill. Your challenges with spouse may happen. Issues with your bosses at work may happen. Issues with teachers and professors at college, if you are that age, may happen. Issues in your neighborhood, issues with your friends may happen. Issues with colleagues may happen. And you will find that you tend to get into losses unnecessarily. Sometimes you will have to change many jobs. Sometimes you may have to change many houses. Sometimes the dasha of a retrograde malefic will force you to go back to your home country if you are working in foreign lands and doing very well. A retrograde Mercury is said to be a planet where, because Mercury gets retrograde every now and then, and we are asked to hang on to the decision, not be in a hurry to take decisions, and communications can be something that can be a challenge, and you may have to communicate two or three times, or there may be a breakdown of communications. If Mercury is retrograde and a malefic in your horoscope, then you will find that communication generally will be a problem with you. You will find that many times you are misunderstood. You say one thing, it is misconstrued to be something else, and your analytical abilities seem to be at a challenge. Sometimes you are very good in your analytical abilities, you analyze situations well, but when the time to come to take a decision comes, the decision rarely seems to go in your favor. Sometimes you don't understand because you have done a lot of hard work to collect a lot of data and then you have taken a decision, yet sometimes the decision seems to not go for you or get stalled, or the result comes out contrary to what the data shows you. So that's what the malefic Mercury does. It puts a severe strain on your ability to analyze situation, to use your intellect, and it also gives you a lot of challenges to clear exams or clear interviews. And many times you may go for many interviews, yet you don't seem to get the opportunity. And with the malefic Mercury, you also seem to be running into challenges with finances. You don't know where your money is going. Many times you face issues, of your savings. You don't seem to save enough. You always seem to spend more, and you don't seem to be making the right financial decisions. So financial decisions, tax issues, having the right decision making, communication issues seem to be a problem with a malefic Mercury. With a malefic Venus in retrograde, you will find that you will have to slog for money, you will have to slog for intimacy, you will have to slog for having better relationships with the opposite sex, to have a good understanding with the opposite gender, to enjoy the fruits of materialistic opulence, to enjoy good food, to be happy generally, to enjoy good music, to enjoy good food, to enjoy good life, a good quality of life. You will see that you will always struggle, and you will seem to be one step backwards to where you want to be. At any given moment, you will find in most of the things in your life there are one step backwards. The kind of car you want, you are one step backward. The kind of home you want to live in, you are one step backward. The kind of relationship you want to be in, you are one step backward. When you want to get married, your marriage may get delayed, relationships may get delayed. Those kind of challenges you may see, you may come across. Venus is malefic and retrograde in your horoscope. Now, more the malefic conjunctions with the malefic retrograde planet and more malefic aspects on it, the challenges will be multifold. And so, the life becomes more and more tougher. Now, how do you overcome or face the challenges of a malefic retrograde planet? The easiest way to handle is to be very, very patient and refrain from doing anything wrong about the manifestation of the retrograde planet. Whatever houses that it rules, be very, very careful of what kind of decisions you take. Any decision you take, take ethical decisions, take thought through decisions, but take them quickly, don't waste too much time on them, and seek wise counsel and be very, very patient. If you get low success, slow success, no success, be patient, don't hurry. Keep working on it, keep slogging on it. Over a period of time, a retrograde malefic planet, once it matures, it will give you results, it will give you very, very strong results. And if it doesn't give you strong results, at least it will save you from the troubles and the challenges that it was throwing at you throughout their life, and that will come out as a big relief for you. If nothing else, if just the relief comes from retrograde malefic planets, that itself is a big boon for you. So the best remedy is donate about the house, about the planet, what its manifestations are, what it is a karaka of, treat the relationship better, don't take any shortcuts about the house. If a retrograde planet is in your 10th house, be very, very careful of what presentations you make, what kind of work that you present. Double check your numbers, double check your presentations, double check the projects that you hand over. Be very careful of who you hire in your team, what kind of mails you send out, when you send out. Never send a mail in anger. Work on your relationship with your supervisors, and even if it takes time and you get slow growth, be patient. Keep working hard, keep asking for your right, but don't be too aggressive about it, because you will find that you will take initial time, you will take fewer steps forward, sometimes some steps backward also. But once you show that you learned the lesson of a retrograde malefic, you are patient and you are ready to put in the hard work, you are ready to wait for the opportunity, wait for the fruits of labor, they will come to you. And if the malefic planet, retrograde malefic planet, is on the edge of a sign, then it will also give you results of the last sign, which means the last sign and last house manifestation will also apply. So keep an eye on them also. Keep an eye on if the retrograde malefic planet is in the third house, then keep an eye on your savings, on your earnings, from where your earnings are coming, how well you are taking care of your savings as well. Rather than just look at marketing, communication, short trips, business opportunities, entrepreneurship, just don't focus on that, because your retrograde planet is in the third house. Also keep a keen eye on the second house, because the second house, the last sign and last house to a retrograde malefic, will also throw up challenges for you every now and then. So friends, look at what planets are retrograde in your horoscopes. They will give you challenges every now and then, even if they are benefic planets, if they are functional malefics, or even if they are benefics and they rule the 6th house or the 8th house or the 12th house, they will throw up challenges for you. If they are functional malefics and they own any of the dustanas, then the challenges will be much, much greater. And if they are placed in the Kendra houses, you will find that you have less control on the manifestations of these planets as well. So be patient, work hard on the results of that house. Over a period of time, better late than never, keep your patience and results will come to you. So friends, like this video, please share this video, and if you're looking for a personal consultation from me, please reach out to me at the links given below. Until some other time with some other video, this is your friend astrologer and guide Irfan signing off. Ciao.